Hello, people. And a little disclaimer. I know two words that can scare the heck out of someone other than your boss saying you're fired or your teacher saying pop quiz. And the two words are public speaking. Yes, that is me practicing the very same speech here on Wednesday. Now, let me give you a little story. Now, don't judge me for the photo. That's grade 5 Naman Berry. That's the best one I could find, actually. So, I had to go up on stage and be part of an assembly. Pretty simple job, but I managed to ruin it too. The simplest thing was I was a pretend dragon, and I had to go up on stage, release my pretend dragon brothers from a pretend cage. Pretty simple, right? I nailed that scene, and as I was exiting the scene, I tripped and I fell on my face. One small mistake created a traumatic memory. My confidence dropped to zero, and I didn't go up on stage till about grade 8. For 3 years, I was scared to be up on stage again. Now, in modern world, to convince someone of your ideas, your viewpoints, you need confidence, and you need to overcome glossophobia. Now, you must be like, hold up, what is glossophobia? It sounds too fancy for me to understand at this point. Glossophobia is a fear of public speaking, and in modern day, it's a very big problem, whether we like to admit it or not. Social Anxiety Institute has done a research that says 27 million Americans are scared of public speaking. That's a staggering number of people. Research done by Columbia University says that it caused a 10% impairment on wages and graduation and up to a 15% impairment on promotions to management. Do we want to be left behind? No. We all want to be sitting in the corner office holding a six-figure check, enjoying the benefits of your job. I know. It sounds like the dream. I take business management in the IB, and my teacher tells us a million-dollar quote, as I call it. If you cannot convince, you cannot sell. And to convince, you need to be confident. The researches that have been done outside the States show similar data. People are scared of public speaking across the world. 23% of Australia's population says that public speaking is their biggest fear, just behind death itself, at 27%. That means about 5.6 million people are afraid of public speaking. That's a lot. Death, you have to catch up. Well, which means about a quarter of the population of Australia. That's a lot of people. And this problem spreads across countries. Now, I know not everyone's interested in public speaking. Not everyone loves being on stage. But for those of you who do, I know everyone has preferences. Some love a theater. Some even love a small class with their class teacher and a small projector behind them. A very simple one. Some people love a podium. I don't like a podium. I like walking around like this stage. It makes me feel open and I can be expressive. But some things we can all take care of, no matter our preferences, are take deep breaths, drink a little water, don't drink too much. You don't want to end up going to the bathroom during your talk. Not at all. Everyone gets nervous. It's okay to be nervous. Everyone does. Even the most prepared person is going to be nervous before they're on stage. It's natural. Take deep breaths and reassure yourself that it's going to be okay. And reassuring is more important than you think. Now, the thing that makes us all nervous has been found to be eye contact. I do not like it when my friends are sitting in the first row, staring dead at me in the eye and laughing, because I know I'm going to screw up because of them. No one likes it. Now, make eye contact with everyone. It's a pretty simple logic. You cannot give a dead-eye stare at one person and be like, hello, today I will be talking about public speaking. No. You do not want to look like a serial killer. Now, public speaking and eye contact go hand in hand. Eye contact can either make or break your speech. Now, how many of you would say when you're giving presentations and doing public speaking events, eye contact makes you nervous? Can you raise your hand? I see there's quite a few people. And yes, it makes me nervous too. That's why I have an idea to solve it. I call it the MTC theory. Now, if there's an MTC right next to you in the theater, can you please raise your hand? Okay, that's good. So, if I'm here and I'm nervous to make eye contact, I'm going to look at that seat to avoid making eye contact with anyone. I'm going to pause to let that idea sink in. Okay, it seems crazy yet. Let me explain how this works. When you make eye contact, there's people looking back at you. But when you look at an empty seat, no one's looking back. It's a pretty simple logic. When you look at an empty seat, no one makes eye contact back at you. You're not nervous. Now, because it's in the middle of the crowd, it looks like you're making eye contact with someone, but it's a loophole. You don't make eye contact with anyone, you don't get nervous, and you don't screw up your presentation. Sounds perfect. Now, let me tell you the most important part. No research has been done on this topic. It's a self-created topic, but if a university gives me tons of grant money, I would. I would research it if I got a lot of money. Who wouldn't? Now, some people might be saying, it sounds too creepy. Why would I stare at an empty seat in the middle of the crowd? Well, we all want to nail that presentation, don't we? Right? But if it's working, and I can tell you with personal experience, when I started out, I did this. When I went back up on stage after grade 8, I started looking at empty seats. When people ask me, how am I so confident? I tell them, I look at an empty seat, and people think I've gone nuts. And people have asked me that, are you crazy? Now, although it doesn't apply to everyone, it is helpful when you're starting out with these things. If you feel nervous, I can assure you it's a very effective way. Now, eye contact can either help you connect and relate to your audience. The audience can either feel, I know what this guy's talking about, or be like, I don't know what this guy's talking about. It can make the small difference between connection and breaking that speech. So, those very empty seats, they could be your key to confidence, connection, and nailing that presentation. Thank you.